Okay, so as I was saying, at E3 this year, we announced with Joseph Gordon-Levitt, we announced a partnership with HitRecord where our fans and everybody around the world can contribute to assets, art assets, music assets on the game, and Emil, or with your friends in co-op. And by the way, you can join in, join out anytime during the adventure so that you team up with your friends. Here, the demo today is going to be two players. So Johan, who just joined, is playing a hybrid monkey character that he completely customized, choose at the beginning of the game, right? You choose your character at the beginning of the game, like any RPG, and you customize it with a weapon, with gear, etc. And Audrey is playing this female character that she also customized, and she customized it so that she looks like a Shani in
Yeah, she can
the
look like
trailers.
Shani, exactly. Yeah.
Boom, maybe you
So
can
yeah,
give us.
to give a bit of context about where the characters are at this point. So we are on the planet Soma, which is one of the main planets in the game, and more specifically, we are in Ganesha City, the city that we saw in our first.
Through their previous adventures, and they led to that place, but they don't exactly know.
Are kind of special abilities, special powers that you will collect as you play along the game, and you can equip those augments either on your gun, your sword, or even on your character, and you can combine them, to create kind of a specific deck. And this will, th these augments will really define the.
There's friendly fire with
Exactly,
augments.
friendly fire with that. So yeah, really the augments will, yeah, like I was saying, will create your own play style and define how you progress in this adventure.
Okay, guys, a hybrid slave.
Yeah.
Then maybe he would have end up in these boxes
Yeah.
and cut down into pieces. So that's to give a bit of context about the world we are living. So we are back on Audrey, who's playing the female character.
Yeah, and she's arriving in this kind of creepy room where we have those scientists. So depending on the augments that the enemies are equipped with,
The fight.
yeah, let's see how these guys handle the fight. So you can see in the fight that the augments take a very, very important role. For instance, you have those domes that will slow down the enemies, so they are very important if you want to have time to actually progress next to your enemies and hit them. They have those
Healing bullets.
healing bullets.
Oh, whoa, nice
Yeah,
freeze.
nice
Three
freeze augments, yeah,
person freeze.
exactly. So we want those combats to be, very, very dynamic, and again, the in those fights.
Yeah, in here we have just only a few samples.
Yeah, exactly. So they did a great job. They
Yeah, good job, guys.
take down all those enemies, and now we can see that one of the hybrids that they were doing experiments on is still alive. So Johan is using the spyglass to scan the players in this game.
Yeah, I said earlier that as a pirate captain, you have a gun, a sword,
Yeah.
and a jetpack. Then you have a ship and a crew as well. That's very
Exactly.
important for us.
And we will see the ship actually in a few
Yeah.
seconds.
Well, now we're gonna go out of this small temple and drive it, right? So now we're gonna go out of this building, as I said, into the city, and this city is Ganesha City. So
We've been seeing a lot of graphical elements that were also coming from our partnership with HitRecord, created by our community.
And this
And
one
this
you're
is
gonna
one.
do.
This one is a huge, of course, a huge fresco, huge murals that has been made by a member of the community. And really, it shows that our cities in the game are kind of a way, a place for people to express themselves and put their own artworks.
Whoop! Careful, Audrey.
So you can expect a lot of places like that in the cities where huge artworks will be displayed and artworks created by our community, which is really something unique.
One thing we want to convey as cities go is the mix between new technology, holograms, and old style monuments, such as this giant statue. Everywhere you see, whatever you see on in the city, you can land on it. There's no hidden wall or free. That's what space pirates want. Then, to convey this freedom feeling, we have this seamless temple, for example. We have some banks
Yeah,
over
over
here.
there,
So if you need some money, you can. Another motorbike, flying motorbike, and we're gonna continue the tour of the city. So
radio in most of the world, because it's the radio that the space pirates are listening to.
And what you're hearing right now has been created by the community.
Exactly. They've been creating jingles, you know, stingers for this space pirate radio called Radio Cheetah. And they've also been created, of course, they've been creating some specific songs, rock and roll songs, and songs that really embody this, you know, rebellious aspect that we want to your experience as a space pirate captain. And one of those aspects is, of course, the ships that will be very, very important for your experience. So here, Audrey is in the customization menu for the ship, and she's changing modules that will actually change, of course, the visual aspect of the game, but also the way you pilot your ship, the statistics of your ship. So you can change the different modules, the wings, the cabin, the engine. Then of course the equipment, the weapons that you put on your ship, and then you have what we call the cosmetic, you know, a customization. So you can change the colors, the patterns on your ship, and of course you can also place a pirate logo on your ship.
Emblems.
An emblem, yeah, exactly. So that's what she's doing now. To see this beautiful statue. And now the police arrived to actually prevent Johan to go too close from this statue.
Because we've got city rules.
Andre has arrived to help him take down all these police ships. And if you take a look around, you will also see that there is a big frigate, a bigger ship owned by the police. And this one is actually too big to be destroyed by the player. Because really important also is that we've been talking about the augments. Ships will also be equipped with augments. Yeah. For instance, you will be able to have some healing missiles to heal your partners in co-op. Yeah. Exactly. So this will also give a lot of depth with those spaceship battles. And here we're seeing an example of a dogfight, of course. Yeah. But you also have to imagine that you will have much more bigger, you know, battles involving motherships.
Yeah. We'll see statue, so that we can see the size of it.
Yeah, it's huge.
Wow. Thank you very
much.
The
detail on the statues.
Nice.
It's amazing. Yeah.
So now that her mothership, which is a ship much bigger than this one, a few thousand kilometers away from where we are. Speeds. Whoops. Nice. So we're gonna fly over Ganesha City. So that's the streets where we were just in before, and they are still. That's the moment that's very important for me, and I like to do it. I want to remind everybody watching that. A few minutes ago, maybe 10 minutes ago, we were inside a small temple fighting some weird scientists, seeing each other, right? We've got the police, we've got the ship system, we've got everything that's coming together in the same shard of gameplay. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That's really what we want to point out, and that's what we think BGN2 is going to be very special to play.
And things are still running in real time. It's important to say that, like you were saying, the city is still active.
Exactly.
And,
exactly.
Everything is still running.
Audrey is going to get out of the spaceship.
Yeah,
the character, you see a small shield effect that's very work in progress. Mm-hmm, it's going to be better looking.
Creations are mysterious geoglyph. So this is a monkey, of course, and those geoglyph will be actually some of them actually will be some hints for some treasures, you know, hidden on the planet. So you will be seeing those geoglyphs as you fly in space, you know, on the planet, and you will have to go
the universe with your spaceship. At this scale of the city, at this scale of the planet, you will be attracted by this giant stuff, and you will be attracted to go and to see. So now it's what we want to show here is our universe map.
Universe map,
right? Place. You can see Ganesha City. You can see we've added for your convenience a lot of icons to show you where you've been, icons to show you where you haven't been. If we zoom back, we see that Ganesha City is actually at the tip of a continent that is looking like India.
India, yeah.
If we go on the other side of the planet, yes, thank you, Audrey. We see that this part of the planet is much less. It's much more hostile. Mm-hmm. And if you want to give,
it's always turned towards space. Mm. So it's frequently bombarded with huge meteorite showers, breaking the ground of the planet and creating these huge.
We can zoom back again. So this is the Deus subsystem scale. Mm-hmm. You can see Deus, the big zoom back again, and that's system three.
Yeah.
And the different locations that we have in system three.
And of course, our day and night cycle in the game.
If you want to come back to, you don't need to stick together in a dungeon. You don't need to stick together in a city, but you don't even need to stick together in the universe. So you're still in the same game universe, but you can go away from your partners and join back again when you fire and flame effect,
yeah,
on the
air friction.
The air friction, yeah, is not there anymore. So now the speeds that Yuan can reach are really limitless, actually.
Exactly.